right, so I want to talk a little bit now about ritual. What is it? Why is it important? But before I do, has anyone here ever been in a mood? Anyone here ever have a mood? Anyone here ever been in a bad mood, a grumpy mood, a happy mood? Okay. How do moods take place? How do moods happen? What happens in a mood? How many people here have ever been in a pretty good mood until someone cuts them off on the road? Do they have road rage in Japan? They have road rage in Japan?
Road rage.
Yeah.
What is it?
You get angry on the driving? Yeah? Wow. Okay. Okay, so what happens? Someone cuts you off on the road, do you leave it there? Does it stop there?
No.
What happens?
You keep going over your mind.
That's right. You go over your mind. Think of the last person who fucked you over. Then think about how someone in fifth grade fucked you up, and then pretty soon you fucking hate the world. Right? You ever get up in the morning in a good mood?
Yes.
What happens when you're in a good mood? What do you do?
I don't know.
What do you do when you're in a good mood?
You have an erection.
You have an erection?
Yeah.
Well, I'm happy to share your mood. You know?
Not quite what I had in mind.
Okay, so that's what gets it going. In a small way. But them dick jokes, Jesus Christ. But then, not to pursue that line of thought, then what happens? Then you start doing things in your mind, you think about how other things in your life are going well. Pretty soon, you're sending your mind in a certain direction, are you not?
Yes.
Okay.
It gets triggered first by wanting them to do it or not.
Right. But then you have to do something to, what you do is you organize your perceptions inside and out in a way that gets you moving in a certain direction. Sometimes some of you will put on some music. You ever put on music to make yourself feel better? Yeah? Or dance around or do something gay like that? Come on. Okay, what is the purpose of a ritual? The purpose of rituals is to organize the inside and the outside to make sure that you get things going and stay going in a certain direction. The purpose of a ritual is to organize things on the inside and the outside and make sure you get everything aligned so it goes in the direction you want it to go. If I give you the world's most powerful magnifying glass, you better make sure it's pointed in the right way, correct? Or you could burn a hole in the wall, or you could look at something up close that you couldn't see before, depending on what you do with it. So there's certain elements to ritual. I want to teach you just some of the basic elements of ritual, okay? We've already been going through one of them, which is the statement of intent. You want to formulate your statement of intent. Why? Let's say it is my statement of intent to make Mary Jo Big Tits fall madly in love with me next time she sees me. Alright? That's your statement of intent. Right? Now, do you want to create in the ritual? Do you want to do a ritual where you create a lot of angry warrior energy? Would that work?
No.
Your statement of intent is going to tell you how to organize the rest of your ritual, what you need to lead in, what you need to make sure you keep out. Does that make sense? Because if you're going to head in a certain direction, you want to make sure that certain things are not there. Does that make sense? Yes?
Yes.
Okay. So the first step in doing a ritual is to formulate your statement of intent. What is it that you want to achieve? Does this make sense?
Yes.
Are you following?
Yes, I'm just interested in why you spell ritual.
R-I-T-U-A-L. That's an R.
I-C-I-C-T.
That's an R.
Oh, now we see it.
What do you think? Ritual?
Ritual.
You're a pervert, I like it. Well, you know, got to keep it in the gutter, or it would be Ross Jeffries' brand, would it?
Like,
if I don't keep it in the gutter, it's not really Ross Jeffries, is it? Okay. So you want to create your statement of intent. What is your statement of intent? Statement of intent usually start off with, it is my will, or this my will, or it is my will too. Now, what do I mean by will? By will, I simply mean focused intent. Your focused intent. By will, I don't mean willpower. Willpower implies a struggle. Do you need willpower to eat? Do you need willpower to eat chocolate ice cream with whipped cream on top? Do you need willpower to eat that? Do you need willpower to get a boner when a beautiful lap dancer rubs your schwanz and shakes her big ones in your face? Do you need willpower to get a boner? No. Okay. Willpower implies a fight against something. That's not what we mean. Will is focused intent. You're taking the single pointed focus of your intent. It's like the difference between a diffused white light and a laser that's so coherent and so focused it can bounce off the moon. Do we understand each other? Yes. So statement of intent. And this ties in. Do we have a different color than blue? Can you toss that to me, buddy? This ties in with one of the major elements of magic. There are three major elements of magic. And one of these is will. Will. I had a teacher who taught me some things and then did some bad things, so I got rid of him. But one thing, someone used to ask him all the time in every seminar, can you make people do things against their will? And the answer is, well, no, you can't, but most people have no will. Most people have a stream of different wishes that flip through their mind, depending on the mood of the moment. But very few people have any will anyway. That's why when you do meet someone who has a focused, congruent intent, they're powerful, and you put your attention on them. Gentlemen, if you want to be more attractive to women, learn to develop your will, not your willpower. Because someone with a focused intent and a passion for life is attractive. They also tend to be narcissistic. So if you can avoid the narcissism and actually pay attention to who she is, if you can combine, on the one hand, being a person with focused, strong intent and a passion for your life, and also someone who really, truly, deeply listens to her and helps her achieve her dreams, if those things were to ever come together and a woman could find them in one place, let me tell you. What? Narcissist is someone who's only totally focused on themselves with no regard for others. Okay. Does this make sense? So, statement of intent ties in with what your will. Therefore, it is my will. Not willpower. Willpower is junk. I tried to use my willpower to stop smoking, but I couldn't do it. Right? Forget about willpower. Although in this country, what are we taught? We're taught the most important thing to success is what? Willpower. We're taught junk in this country.
Yeah, first you don't succeed,
try harder. Tense those muscles up. Why believe in being flexible and persistent? And agile and persistent. Okay, so you've got to formulate their statement of intent. Does that make sense? The second element of ritual is what we call banishment. I'm going to explain what that means in a moment. Banishment. Actually, let's not make that the second. I'm going to jerk you around a little. Let's make the second energize with breath.
In any ritual I think that works, you have to energize your body with breathing. Somehow the energy of breathing involves your body in the process, using your body is part of what makes it work. So energize yourself with breath. We're going to show you some of that. Third thing is, you need to banish. And banish simply means clearing a space for working. Clear a space for working. When you clear a space for working, what you're essentially doing is setting up an anchor in your physical environment that says, in this space, in this place, only what I bring forward with my will and my energy and my imagination and intent is going to be what's created. Anything that doesn't contribute to that, you're out of here. You understand? So what you do when you banish, we're going to show you some simple ways to do that, is to clear a space, a ritual space for working in which your will, your intent, your energy are what matters and nothing else matters. And anything that doesn't contribute has to go, has to leave, has to get out of there. Does that make sense? So banishment. You want to alter your state. As part of this, you want to create a state of mind where you believe anything can be possible. Anything can be possible. Alter, A-L-T-E-R, or alter. I'm playing a little pun there. Alter your state. Create a state of mind where you believe anything can be possible. Why would that be useful? Yes, Gino. Yeah, so you don't sabotage yourself. Also, if you're creating a place where you believe anything could be possible, where are you not looking? Right, you're not looking into your past.
There's no limits.
There's no limits, exactly. Yes, for those of you who have a scientific perspective on things, I tend to think of this place as the quantum soup. It's the place where every possible universe that could manifest is equally ready to manifest. The only difference is as to which one actually becomes real is what my will selects. Is that a little delusional? Maybe, but since it only takes place in a little circle, it's okay. You're going to have delusions, make them useful, and confine them to a physical space. So, otherwise, you will be confined. How to build a building a better psychotic. Available from Ross Corps. Alter your state. All right. Step five is use symbology, which we will get to. Use symbology. The branch of magic that I enjoy, chaos magic, encourages you not to use traditional symbology. Traditional symbology has very little meaning to the modern mind. For example, back in the days when everyone carried a dagger had a lot of meaning. Nowadays, you're more likely to find people carrying Walkmans and MP3 players than daggers. Is that correct? Yes?
Yes.
Back in the good old days, crystal balls had a lot of meaning. Nowadays, more people have seen television sets than they have crystal balls. Correct? I had a student who had a terrible shyness problem with women, so we invoked a god. We didn't invoke Zeus or Thor or Jesus. We invoked Pepe Le Pew, the cartoon skunk, who is a magnificent lover. I think I may have to do a Pepe Le Pew ritual with one of you. Who's a little bit shy with women still? Come on. You? Yes? Yeah. You? Mr. Writerman, yeah. What's your name?
Ryan.
Are you a little shy with women?
Yeah.
Yeah? Yeah. We're going to invoke Pepe. I'm going to do an invocation of the god Pepe Le Pew. Do you have any religious objections to that? Why? Do you know who Pepe Le Pew was? Is?
Yeah.
Who's Pepe Le Pew? Tell me. And what? How does he talk?
Yeah.
Well, let's hear it. Like what?
Yeah. I am Pepe Le Pew.
I am Pepe.
Please, darling.
Please, darling. Shari, why are you resisting me? You get the I had this student imagine a big fluffy tail growing. He had fun. He went out and talked to tons of women. All right, so you want to come up with symbology that means something for you. And finally, what you want to do is you want to close the ritual. Close. Let it go. Rebanish. Here's the thing you don't want to do. Anyone here ever bake a cake or bake something in the oven? I don't care. What happens if you keep checking the oven to see if it's ready? First introduction to sigils. A sigil is a word, a remote influence, works by signals being sent. Emotions. What you haven't yet considered is that the walls also keep your limitations. Today's magic is fun too. You can why